and welcome to this presentation. My name is Mohammad Shehab, and I am a postdoctoral researcher at the University of Oulu and the 6G flagship. I am also part of the Machine Type Communication Wireless Group, or simply MTC, and in this presentation, I will illustrate a compilation of examples about the role of machine learning in MTC according to what we have been doing in the last couple of years. My presentation is divided into three parts. In the first part, I will introduce machine learning and applications related to MTC traffic management. In the second part, I will explain our research endeavors on machine learning for UAV trajectory planning to collect information from massive number of grounded MTC devices. Finally, I will shed some light on the applications of meta learning for non-orthogonal multiple access. Let's have an overview on machine learning approaches. Main classes of machine learning include supervised, unsupervised, and reinforcement learning. These classes are extended to deep learning, distributed federated learning, and meta learning. Each of these algorithms is suitable for a specific type of problems. For instance, reinforcement learning is able to adapt to dynamic behavior and problems which are changing with time. Meanwhile, the deep Q learning is more suitable to deal with problems with high dimensionality, as it is able to sample the large action and state spaces and reduce the problem complexity. A question that might come to mind here: when to apply machine learning and when to apply conventional model-based mathematical approaches. In this figure, we illustrate that conventional mathematical tools are more feasible to apply when there are convex problems, when there are problems with a small number of variables, when the number of parameters are small, when the problems have static conditions, when the problems have small data sets. Meanwhile, it is more feasible to apply machine learning for high dimensional problems which are mathematically untractable, for problems with dynamic conditions and massive number of variables, and when there exists large data sets. Let me introduce my PhD student, Islam Ildeep, who is working on machine learning related problems, and he is solving problems related to machine type communication, traffic classification and management, and also he is working on UAV assisted machine type communications, as will be explained in the next slides. The behavior of MTC traffic is quite different from human type communication. This is due to the fact that machine type communication traffic is more coordinated and could be periodic, reacting to specific events, while human type communication traffic is not coordinated and cannot be expected. Moreover, machine type communication traffic usually use short packets and small number of packets to convey messages. Furthermore, machine type communication quality of service constraints are usually more strict and does not tolerate long delays. For instance, in human type communication, it wouldn't be a problem if in video conversations or in video conversations there is a delay of 500 milliseconds or half a second. That would be fine. However, in machine type communication, in applications such as remote surgery, it would be a big issue if there is a delay that is more than 100 milliseconds, or it is very sensitive to delay. In this context, we published a journal paper on fast uplink grant for Markovian MTC models. And this paper was published in IEEE IoT Journal. In this paper, we consider multiple Markovian events that control the activation of machine-type devices. And these Markovian events go from the alarm to the data states according to Markov chain. And next, we have here the four possible patterns of activation of the devices. And in the beginning, we have the startup pattern, and then the devices when they transmit data. And then when an alarm occurs at a certain position, the devices that are closer to this position are more likely to generate alarm data, or due to a certain event, for example, forest fire or whatever alarm occurs. And then when the alarm gets off, these devices become silent. And in order to capture the proximity of this alarm, we apply support vector machines with Gaussian kernels. And then we perform time prediction for the data alarm patterns and the traffic prediction for these devices using recurrent neural networks and long short-term memory, as shown in this figure. And the results are illustrated in this slide, where the proposed approach, which applies LSTMs for predicting the traffic pattern of the MTC devices and providing proactive resource allocation for these devices. This proposed algorithm renders higher throughput and lower access delay when compared to other grant-based random access and random fast uplink grant, as shown in these figures. In another context, we published several papers on data collection from grounded MTC devices using drones. The target was to minimize the age of devices and the energy consumption of the drones. The age is a metric that determines the degree of freshness of information collected from grounded devices. This indicates whether the devices are able to upload their data frequently enough or not. In order to solve this problem, in this scenario, we have a number of grounded devices, and there are batteries on the corners of the map, and there are one or two UAVs collecting the information from devices, and these drones are flying around the map, and each drone have a certain coverage area where it can obtain information from the devices. We apply reinforcement learning, and to apply reinforcement learning, we formulate the problem as a Markov decision process, and there are four components of a Markov decision process. The first component is the agents, and here the agent is the UEV or multiple UEVs in case we have multiple UEVs. The second component is the state space, and here we have the states, which are the age of the devices, the location of the drones, and the location of the devices. The third component of the Markov decision process is the action space. And here the action space consists of which device is going to be scheduled and in which direction the drone is going to move in the next time step. And the fourth component of the Markov decision process is the reward function. And in this reward function, the reward becomes higher if the age of information is lower, and we penalize the devices which transmit outside the coverage area of the UEVs so that they learn how to transmit within the coverage area in order to minimize their energy consumption. In order to solve this reinforcement learning problem, we apply Q-learning, and the Q function, which is the main function to solve the Q-learning problem, evaluates how good for the agent at a state to select a specific action. And this iterative problem is solved using this formula given here. To solve such problems with high dimensionality, we resort to even more advanced type of Q learning, which is called the deep Q learning or deep Q networks. The results here show that when applying deep reinforcement learning using deep Q learning, the age of information of the devices is much lower when compared to the random walk scenario. And we consider two cases, the 5-directional moving drone and the 9-direction of freedom moving drone. And as we can see also that the 9 directions of freedom can give lower age when compared to the 5 directions of freedom. Moreover, when increasing the number of devices, still we have the same performance, that the age of information of devices is lower in case of applying deep reinforcement learning, especially when having a higher number of UAVs. When having 2 UAVs, this results in lower age of information. And finally, we have the result of the battery of the UAV on the right. And in this result, it is shown that deep reinforcement learning not only minimizes the age of information of the devices, but also saves the battery of the drones. And the available energy levels, the available energy at the drone is quite higher when applying deep reinforcement learning. In order to solve the same problem for higher number of devices, we perform clustering. And here, in order to perform clustering, we apply k-means clustering, unsupervised learning. And the number of devices per cluster is determined according to the transmission rate and the packet size and the velocity of the UAV. And this paper was already published in IEEE Transactions on Vehicular Networks. And in this paper, we have multiple clusters of devices and multiple drones that are collecting the information from the devices, from the grounded devices. In order to show the performance of the proposed clustering and the deep reinforcement learning trajectory planning of the UAVs, we consider a map in which devices are deployed around the map, and the right upper corner of the map is more congested than the other parts of the map. And as we can see in the left part of the screen, that when applying deep reinforcement learning, the drones tend to fly closer to the congested area of the map on the upper right part. On the right part of the screen, we can see the trade-off between the age of information and the energy consumption for the proposed deep reinforcement learning algorithm. And we can see that the proposed solution provides a smooth trade-off when compared to the greedy algorithm, which results in the lowest age of information, and to the nearest neighbor algorithm, which minimizes the energy consumption. And the trade-off between the age of information and the energy consumption is shown on the different curves. And in all cases, the proposed algorithm provides lower age and lower energy consumption when compared to the random walk, the greedy algorithm, and the nearest neighbor algorithm. In the context of UAVs, finally, we have the UAV swarm application, in which we also have the clusters. And these clusters are served by a massive number of UAVs, up to 10 UAVs. And this paper was published quite recently in PIMRC in Canada. And in this paper, we apply multi-agent reinforcement learning in order to solve this problem, as the problem suffers from high dimensionality when introducing large number of UAVs to obtain information from the grounded MTC devices. And here we compare between the centralized conventional reinforcement learning, the cooperative multi-agent reinforcement learning, which shares the information, the state and action information to the other UAVs. Then we have the partially cooperative multi-agent reinforcement learning, where the training is performed locally at the UAVs, and then the UAVs can share their actions only to the base stations without sending information to the other UAVs. And finally, we have the fully decentralized or the fully distributed multi-agent reinforcement learning, where the UAVs run their training locally and does not share any information with the base station or the other devices or the other UAVs. And the results are depicted here in this figure, where we can see that the centralized reinforcement learning provides the best performance when compared to others. However, centralized reinforcement learning is not able to scale to a higher number of UAVs when the UAVs are above 3. For example, if the number of UAVs is 5 or 10, which is called a UAV swarm, we are not able to apply centralized reinforcement learning. And then the best performer here is the multi-agent reinforcement learning, the cooperative version. And this provides the lowest age of information when compared to the other versions of the multi-agent reinforcement learning. And these results are taken for a massive number of devices. And we have the 300 devices deployed in the map, and the 10 or 5 UAVs collecting information from these devices. And here I'm introducing also my other student. She is Heba Talla Issa. She is working on meta-learning approaches for non-orthogonal multiple access. In this part, we have a paper also published in the last version of EUCNC. And in this paper, we apply meta-learning for non-orthogonal multiple access uplink using few pilots from MTC devices. And there is no prior knowledge of channel state information. And meta-learning is about learning to learn. So the idea of meta-learning is to accumulate experience when a device transmits its information to the base station, and the base station performs channel estimation using a specific learning technique, then the base station is able to accumulate its learning experience in order to facilitate and expedite the learning for the other devices and the learning of the channels of the other devices. And the results are quite promising, since when applying meta learning with successive interference cancellation, the symbol error rate for this kind of learning is much lower than the deep learning version. This also applies to different number of pilots and the different values of signal-to-noise ratios, as can be seen from the two figures in the screen. I would like to thank you for listening. Please feel free to contact me or any of my students for questions, discussions, or if you are interested in collaboration. Thank you.